Hello students, so after completing and attending questions for biomolecules and cell structure and function, today we are going to attend questions of cell cycle and cell division. Now before we start working on these questions, I have a very exciting news for you. So I have decided that every month's last Friday, I will give out free test questions, test papers to few select of you. So keep an eye out. I will let you know on the Friday lecture. Okay, so this week we will be attending cell cycle and cell division. Let's start our practice. Okay, so the first question is, duration of a typical human cell cycle is about. Okay, now let me take decent color. So typical cell cycle, okay, so this is a fact based question. The answer is 24 hours. Okay, and if you are curious, I will also tell you. Now you know in a cell cycle there are basically G1, S, G2 and M. Okay, so a 24 hour can be divided as 11 hours, 8 hours, 4 hours, hours, and just 1 hour. So you can see how much is this? 11, 8, 19, 23, 24. Okay. So you can see G1 is the longest part of the cell cycle and M phase is the shortest. Okay. So that's something you can remember by. And let's move on to the next question. Okay. So the next question is, two successive M phases are separated by. Okay, so let's say this is the whole cell cycle. M phase is just a small part, okay, and the rest of this is called interphase. Okay, and as we have seen in the previous, this is comprising of three components: G1, S and G2. G stands for gap, okay, and S stands for synthesis. Okay, all right. So two successive M phases are separated by interphase. Okay, so the best answer is interphase. Let's move on to the next one. Cell growth is a, okay, so cell growth occurs always. Cell growth means increase in cytoplasm. Okay, so it's a continuous process. That's something you have to remember. Cell growth is continuous process. Okay, so if the DNA content of a cell is 5 picograms at S phase, what will be the amount of DNA after meiosis 2? Okay, so the options are in picograms, but if you don't know, picogram means 10 raised to power minus 12 grams. Okay. Just remember this. So nanogram you must already know, 10 to the power minus 9, and there is something called femto, spelling is femto, that is 10 to the power minus 15, and then there is something called atto, that is 10 to the power minus 18. Okay, that's something not related to this question, but you can always have use for them. Okay, so if the DNA content of the cell is 5 picogram at S phase, okay, one more thing, you can pause the video and if you want to try it yourself and come back to see the answer. Okay, so if the DNA content of the cell is 5 pic at S phase, this is important. S phase means synthesis, that means DNA has already doubled. Okay, synthesis means DNA synthesis, DNA has doubled. And That means a diploid or a 2N DNA amount would be how much? 2.5 picogram. Okay, and then what is the question? What will be the amount of DNA after meiosis 2? Now we know meiosis is a reduction division. Okay, so the amount of DNA halves. So therefore amount will be half from this. Okay, so that means answer is 1.25 picogram, which is our first option. So the best answer is 1.25 picogram. Okay, let's move on to the next one. Lambrush chromosomes occur in. Okay, so this is a fact-based question. Lambrush chromosomes occur in diplotene of meiosis. Okay, it occurs in most of the vertebrates except mammals. And that is one more thing. This is also called as diplotene chromosome. Okay, so if you have got all the five questions correct, let me know in the comments. If you have any doubts, please let me know. We'll clear up in the next. So this week we'll have more questions on Wednesday and on Friday from cell growth and cell division and cell cycle. And I will also announce how you can get those free test papers. Okay, all right, see you on Wednesday. Have a good one. Stay safe, have fun, study well. Bye bye.